So guys, for the month of July, one of the games that they allowed us to have for free is Until Dawn. Some of you guys may have played it already. This is the first time I'm playing it. And that scared the crap out of me. So, I like the graphics of... Oh, shoot. You could actually control her head. Right? I can control your head? Oh, look how her eyes roll back. Oh, yeah. Very realistic. Her teeth even look uneven. Come on, baby. Open your mouth again. Okay. She doesn't want to anymore. I don't know, can I? Can I control? No, I can't control her eyes. So, I'm gonna dive right in. This is the first time I'm ever playing Until Dawn. I don't know what to expect. I think it's a horror game, because the way it looks, and the way the intro already scared the crap out of me. So let's take a look to see what's in store. The butterfly effect. Tiny butterfly flapping its wing. Devastating hurricane. One of those games that I gotta make decisions. Choose your actions carefully. I take that as a yes.
And it's not her fault that she has a huge crush on Mike.
Anna's been making the moves on him. I'm just looking out for my girl, Em.
Just because he's class prez doesn't mean he belongs to everyone. Mike is my man.
Hey, Em, I'm not anybody's man.
Whatever you say, darling.
Oh yeah, because that's not creepy at all.
She's here. Shh. Mike. Mike? It's Hannah.
Hey, Hannah.
Just be us this weekend. Josh.
All right. Guys passed out drunk. Is there anything here? Ooh, hit X. Tutorial. Press. No,
God. What did our naive sister get herself into now? Ugh. Intervention time.
Ooh. What did I do?
Jeez, Josh. Once again, brother, you've outdone us all. I got your note.
Glad you could make it. Maybe we should start with a little, you know, making out and see where it goes from there.
You guys are such jerks.
Hannah.
I'm sorry, Hannah.
Hey,
this all got
out of just a stupid prank.
Hey,
you guys are jerks. You know that?
That's what I said. Should I find others or should I wake Josh? I'm gonna wake up Josh.
Josh! Josh! Fuck! Guys, there's someone outside. What the hell? Hannah!
Anna Banana!
Where's my sister going?
It's fine. She just can't take a joke.
It was just a prank, Han. What did you do?
We're just messing around, Beth. It wasn't serious.
You jerks! Hannah! Hannah!
So, should we go after her?
Oh, duh.
You know, I kind of think you're the last person she wants to see right now, Mike.
Oh, shit!
So, the remote chirps at you. Let's go the fast route. So yeah, the remote chirps at you in order for you to know how much time you have on the to make your decision in the game. I don't think I do pretty well with that. Just follow the noise. Oh, wait, I think I just saw her on the right. But I think I just saw something on the left. Oh my gosh. Let's go to the right. I thought she was getting ready to take a selfie. Oh, sweet. I can control where the light goes. That's different. Oh man, it startled me. Yeah, let's walk a little faster then.
Hello?
Hi.
Hello?
Hello, Anna? Oh, what's this? Oh. What? Death totem. Huh. Found on the mountain by Beth. Okay, so your character traits do increase. Apparently you have relationship statuses. The twins, okay, don't know anything about that yet. Alright, I think I'm just starting to jump ahead of myself here. So let's take a look, see what's around here. Huh? Anna! Anna Banana! Anna Banana! Telling mom. What the heck?
What the hell
yeah.
Was that?
I don't know what that was.
Hannah. Hannah.
What?
Hannah. Oh my god, you must be freezing. Here, take my coat. I'm such an idiot. I'm so dumb.
Run, bitch! Get up! Get up! Great, you dropped your phone. Let go. I died. Both died.
I need to make sure you understand. You see, no one can change what happened last year. The past is beyond our control. You have to accept this in order to move forward. But there is freedom in this revelation. Everything you do, every decision you make from now on will open doors to the future. I want you to remember this. I want you to remember this as you play your game. Every single choice will affect your fate and the fate of those around you. So, you have committed to commence with this game. This is significant. And I want to help you see it through. Sometimes these things can be a little scary, even terrifying, but I'm here to make sure that no matter how upsetting things may get, You will always find a way to work through it. All right. We will start with a simple exercise. Could you please pick up the card? And I want you to look at the picture on the other side and tell me what you feel about it. It is essential that you answer honestly in order to get the most out of this experience. So, how did that picture make you feel? Remember, be honest.
I feel uneasy.
Okay, honesty is good. What do you think it is that makes you feel uneasy? Well, I see. Let's see. The scarecrow were not there. Would you feel comfortable staying there on your own for a period of time? Say a week, for example.
No, I wouldn't stay there.
Oh, no? Why not?
I'd be alone. No friends.
There's a fine line between the peacefulness of solitude and the loneliness of isolation. Perhaps this is something we can explore in the future. Because I'm afraid we're out of time. Not for now. Until the next session. And until then, try to surround yourself with friends in a place that makes you feel safe.
Wait, that was just the introduction? Whoa. Well, so far I like this game. Can't wait to see what the game's gonna show me later on in the future. Huh.
Of the dreadful tragedy that took place on Mount Washington. Annie Klein was in charge of the investigation.
Thanks for having me, Marty.
Listeners, an update on Hannah and Beth Washington, the twins who are still missing.
1 year ago tonight, the Washington girls left the safety of their parents' lodge and headed out into a snowstorm.
Foul play.
Not officially, no. There is one individual we're considering as a person of interest, but his whereabouts are currently unknown. He has an interesting history with the Washington family. He had warned them against pursuing their construction project and claimed the land was sacred to his forefathers.
You know, there is still the old sanatorium on the mountain. Could he be hiding there?
My officers did search the grounds, but the girls themselves couldn't have made it that far.
Something about that mountain seems to breed tragic events.
More than you know, Marty.
Thank you for joining us, Annie. With all the Washingtons tonight, their son Josh, on this, the anniversary of the mysterious disappearance of Hannah and Beth Washington.
Well, hello, friends and fans.
All right, let's do that again.
That reminds me of me.
Well,
I'm going to try to record myself.
Friends and fans, it's beyond awesome. awesome to have you guys all back this year. First off, I gotta say, I am super excited to welcome all my pals back to the annual Blackwood Winter Getaway. Let me just let you know, let's take a moment to address the elephant in the room for a second.
I'm not in the room.
You're all probably worried about me, and I know it's gonna be tough on all of us going back after what happened last year, but I just want you all to know, it means so much to me that we're doing this, and that I know it would mean so much to Hannah and Beth that we're all still here together, and I'm thinking of them. I really want to spend some quality time with each and every one of you, and just share some moments that we'll never forget for the sake of my sisters, and, you know. Okay, so let's party like we're fucking porn stars, okay? Make this one trip we will never forget, all right? Yes!
All right. Hey, that's still the introduction? Oh my gosh, this intro is long. So the other game that was available to us is Game of Thrones. Many of you have seen the show. I have yet to see the show. I don't know if it really catches my attention. Frankly, I don't got the time for it. But let's see what this game's about. As soon as it's done loading. There we go. Season finale, episode 6. Ice Dragon is now available. Play episodes, Telltale. Oh man. Okay, so it's a Telltale game, which means it's another decision-based game. Let us take a look. Another decision-based game.
The trout in the towers, the wolf dropped the fish and they all ran away. The trout, he fought off for hours.
Another ball of prey.
Two weddings
brought on by the Eddings.
I've actually never played a Telltale game. I've seen other people play, but this is going to be the first Telltale game I've ever played.
Let's see how they are. Oathbreaker, brought to his knees by the men of the North.
been set free by the women. You'd think he'd done it himself the way he tells it.
The Until Dawn game
Claude
was
Forrester's
good.
Sword won't clean itself, you know.
I doubt it was Telltale. I didn't really pay attention to see who it was. But I really enjoyed that game.
Make sure it's spotless
this
time.
Like
Claude Forrester won't be happy with blood and brains all over it. Go on. It's only blood. Now that is a proper sword.
I'll have one like it myself someday.
You'll never have a sword like that. I say that as a friend. And if we're being honest, you are just a squire.
Why not?
You don't give swords like that to pig farmers.
I had a hand in it, you know.
A hand in what?
Capturing him.
He was nowhere near the Kingslayer at the Whispering Wood. He was so drunk, he barely made it out of his tent. Next, he'll tell us he caught Tyrion, too.
Shh. Let him finish.
Oh, he'll talk all night if you let him.
You captured the Kingslayer?
Aye. Well, I had a hand in it.
Aye. And round his ankle as 10 others took him down.
See? What do I tell you?
I brought him to his knees.
Lord Forrester.
But not before he dragged you halfway across the battlefield on your face.
You're questioning Norrin's honor.
I'm questioning Norrin's story. Which grows more far-fetched every time he tells it.
Get your liege lord some wine.
Go on.
It's your job.
Right, thanks.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Garrett. I'll do it. Norrin's family has faithfully served House Forrester for centuries. His honor is beyond reproach, and House Tully is forever in his debt. You've never seen a field plowed so well as the day the Kingslayer dragged poor Norrin across the battlefield. Fetch your cup. Tonight we celebrate. To Robb Stark, the King in the North!
The King in the North!
Tomorrow, we march on Casterly Rock, and House Forrester has been given the greatest honor to lead the Young Wolf's army and ride as the vanguard!
The gods have favored us.
Onward! To Casterly Rock!
Aye!
Death to the Lannisters!
Aye!
Winter is coming!
Aye!
Let's hope it waits till this bloody war's over.
Garrett.
Yes, my lord?
I need you to keep an eye out for Roderick.
As his father, I could not be more proud of the man he's become.
On a night like this, men find false courage at the bottom of their cups. I'd rather he were here.
Yes, my lord.
Is also the question, what's to be done with you?
It's been on my mind for a while now. Something must be done.
With me, my lord?
You've served House Forrester well for several years now, but I can't expect you to squire forever. How shall I reward your loyalty? What can
Give
I offer
me a million
you?
Dollars?
Served me well.
To bring honor to House Forrester, my lord.
You have more honor than those who were born to it. There were those who had their doubts when your uncle put forth your name as my squire. But you've erased those doubts entirely. It would be an honor to see you riding by Roderick's side in the vanguard tomorrow. Not as a squire, but as the equal of any man who serves House Forrester. It's well deserved, Garrett. Your hard work has paid off.
Thank you, my lord. I promise. I won't let you down.
That I don't doubt. But for now, keep this between us. We're celebrating tonight. I wouldn't want the other squires to feel discouraged.
Yes, my lord.
Now go and find Roderick if you can.
I will, my lord. Thank you.
Bloody hell.
Squire! Fetch us more wine!
Can you give me a hand? Come on. Make it up to you.
Yeah, no problem.
I have been a squire longer than you.
So?
I outrank you. You should help me.
You're a douchebag.
Let's grab my armor, clean my boots. Just my luck to end up with Norrin while you serve the Lord. Let him fetch his own wine for once. He's a drunk, a liar, and an arrogant prick.
You'd better watch your tongue, Bowen. It could be much worse.
What the fuck do you know about it? Nothing is worse than Norrin. See, that's where you're lucky. Low expectations. If I'd grown up covered in pig shit, shovel and slop, well, maybe I'd think saddling his horse was the greatest honor in the Seven Kingdoms. I suppose this beats pig farming. But not by much.
Who doesn't love bacon?
I love bacon.
Ah, pig farmers. All I'm saying is, at this rate, we'll never be more than this, which is nothing. The lowest of the low.
Comment below if you love bacon.
We could be squires for life. All in wine around a fucking wedding.
I'm sick of listening to your whine. With that attitude, you'll never be more than this.
Easy for you to say. Maybe if my uncle were Castellan, I'd feel different.
Who my uncle is has nothing to do with it. How much further?
It's right over there. Take your time.
You lot have drunk your share. Good thing Lord Walder's in a generous mood.
Fucking phrase.
Nice night for a wedding. Not often he finds a willing husband for one of his daughters.
Don't expect me to carry it for you, Sir Garrett. What's wrong? What's gotten into you? You're acting rather odd.
Nothing. I'm fine.
I'm so glad to hear it. Now take the fucking flagon already.
What's wrong with him? Something the matter?
Bowen, we have to go.
You go if you're in such a rush.
We have to warn the others.
Good luck.
Oh my gosh. I did not see that one coming. Well, guys, that was kind of fun, I guess. Yeah, I already got shot. But don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow me on Twitter. I will be posting further episodes of my gameplay on Game of Thrones, as well as Until Dawn. The only way you can know that is if you subscribe and follow me on Twitter as to when they will be posted. Thank you, and I hope you guys enjoyed.